future, talk radio will actually educate, inspire, and make you think. The future is now. Topics and music that affect your life from Universal Broadcasting Network. Tune in at ubnradio.com.
Hit it, girl.
Come on, toss it up. Toss it up.
Come on, toss it up.
And toss that up.
Toss it up. Ooh, toss it up.
Toss it up.
Come on, toss it up.
Toss it up.
Hey, toss it up. Toss it up. Toss it up.
Woo!
Toss it up, honey.
How are you? Hello, America.
Hello, America. Hello.
Cheers.
Cheers to that.
And I brought you a special drink.
Oh, ginger, is that for us?
Ginger, yes, it is for us. As a matter of fact, and Lindsay, our friend here, will be bringing us little pretty cups.
Oh, sweet. Well, hello, world.
I am
Audrey Turner.
I'm Heidi Ho. Sorry, Heidi Selexa. What?
Don't
people call me Heidi Ho sometimes when you're my good friend?
We are.
Toss it up.
Toss it up, honey. Now, Heidi, Heidi Ho. Heidi, Heidi, Heidi Ho.
Sing it. I want that Heidi High. I want that Heidi.
What's this guy's name back in the day? Heidi, 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 Heidi Ho.
Who did, I want
what's his name?
Heidi,
Heidi. Way back. I don't know.
Steve Miller Band.
No, forget it.
Abracadabra.
No, Heidi, Heidi, Heidi Ho.
Oh, with Lynyrd Skynyrd.
No.
Jim Peterik.
No.
Journey.
No.
Styx.
Forgot it.
Bob Dylan.
No.
Jimi Hendrix. Ike Turner. Oh!
And we're rolling on the river. Say we're rolling.
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 And rolling. Rolling on your river.
Okay,
the river.
See. I can't do it, people. It's not going to happen.
I don't sing. Today. Right? I do. I suck. I'm like my own brand.
But
I'm the Heidi Ho sucks at singing.
I like it, though.
You know what I mean? But you can sing it by yourself.
No, I'm done. You suck and I rock, but I like it.
Well, you suck and I rock at other things.
That's true.
And I like that.
But I wonder what could that be?
Oh, well, I'm not... I don't know what she's talking about, okay? But it ain't happening down there, okay? Not where you're going.
When they go low, I go high all the time.
Well, that's why it's the Heidi High.
Heidi, 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 ho.
It should be the...
I almost had it.
Hit it again.
Cab Calloway.
Hit it again.
Cab Calloway.
Oh.
Heidi, 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 Heidi. And everybody goes, like I say, Heidi, 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 Heidi.
Heidi, 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 hi.
Heidi, 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 ho.
Heidi, 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 ho.
And then they dance and the horns go boom, 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 boom,
boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom.
Yes.
I like that. See,
so,
you could. I have rhythm. I just
you
can't.
Do.
I don't have tune.
I'll take it back.
I have no pitch. I have no level. I have no pitch, and I can't really hear my headphones. That's probably part of the problem.
Well, I take it back. You do not suck.
I do suck.
Okay.
I do. I totally do. It's fine. I can bring home the bacon. Really good.
Yeah.
And happy birthday. That's it. That's okay. That's as far as my vocal cords will go.
Those
I'm not like you, Audrey Turner, who was discovered by Ike Turner when you were like 3 years old.
Oh.
Hello.
Okay.
Can I hear myself in my headphones?
Discovered.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know what I mean. You
that's
were,
sweet.
You
I love
were
it.
Discovered,
yeah.
You were born discovered. So,
born discovered.
And I was too, but
like
in
that.
More of the comedy area. Isn't she cute and can hold a crowd?
No,
okay.
Yeah, cutie pie.
I'm not a baby anymore. However, I have to tell you.
I'm a baby at heart.
I have to tell you, Audrey.
I like that Jarvis. You better work,
Lord.
Jarvis.
Jarvis, why are you wearing a jacket today? You take
it's
that
hot
off.
Air.
Take it off. Take it off. Give us some of that chocolate. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying.
Give her some of that chocolate drop. Okay.
So did you just, were you born with that ability to sing?
I was. I was born from the crib singing and popping my fingers and like being in tune to harmony of the universe. Speaking of that, let me just tell you about harmony of the universe.
I'm not, oh yes. Well, we got things to talk
about.
Well,
let me talk about this though. First of all, you know, I was riding with a friend yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
I lost my makeup bag. I am so freaking...
You lost your entire makeup bag?
My entire Louis makeup bag.
You got to be. Did it have all of your good makeup?
All of everything, like my, oh my stuff gosh. And my eyeliner and my lipstick and my my eyebrow pencil and my blush.
Everything you're so
every
used to.
Every freaking thing. Let me tell you why I lost it. It's because when I get in the car, like my bag is really heavy. So I usually take my makeup bag out and then I set it to the side.
I do that too.
And so when I got in his car, I took my makeup bag out and I set it to the side. Well, like underneath
Who's
the seat.
Him?
Just my dear friend, and then underneath the seat. And then when I got back, well, I didn't ride with him back. I rode with another friend, and I left my makeup bag in the car. And then when we got to the destination, I said, oh, I'll get it. And I didn't get it, and he drove off. And so I'll get it in a couple of days when he and his wife come and bring it to me.
Oh, no. So you don't really need makeup, though.
No, I don't. But I don't have my red. Like, I love red lipstick.
No, but pink is great. I had light pink on. I didn't put my bright orange.
Thank God.
I just put on light pink. I said Au Naturel today.
Thank God I had my pink lipstick in my purse.
Right.
And then I asked my niece.
Because
I said,
if you don't have the lipstick, at least one lipstick that looks good on you. Oh, my gosh.
At least my lips will look pretty without it anyway. But
I know, but it's just the habit.
Yeah, I just want it. So like, I'm really peeved about that. So this week, I will have no makeup until Saturday.
That's great. Your skin's going to love you.
Thank you.
You know that. You don't really need it. You don't need it.
I don't.
No. Well, then Jarvis, she doesn't need makeup. You would stare at her if you were kissing her and go, you're pretty. Without makeup, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that's how you know when guys do that. I love when they do that to me.
Yeah, they do.
Because they really.
Well, I don't know. I haven't had a kiss in 8 years.
Oh, I'm
sorry. I'm not trying to get one.
Jarvis.
No, Jarvis can't be kissing on Audrey. And then, like I said, I'm coming up in here working and looking at Jarvis going, oh, hell, I hope Jarvis ain't in there tonight. Then me and Jarvis be sinemies and, you know, and frenemies. And I'm not going to say the other word. And you know. For me,
he's gonna be sending you like smiley faces upside down.
I'll be like,
not
here,
great today, Audrey.
You know,
one time I came.
We got
to
a good thing. I love Jarvis.
I know. Isn't he lovely?
Don't be trying to mess that up, girl.
I'm not trying to mess.
Don't try to mess it up.
Jarvis and I talk on the phone all the time till wee hours of the night.
You know, I heard.
This week we talked probably 5 hours. I loved it.
Did
we
you
talk?
Go to sleep again, Jarvis? Oh,
no.
Wait. And
actually,
then,
this time he stayed awake.
Oh, good.
It was very entertaining. What we were talking about.
Really?
Yeah.
Can I tell you, finish telling you what happened to me during the week?
I do want to tell
like,
you
really?
Because I have big news for you.
Okay, this is some big news here. But it's like who's the biggest? It's just like, let me finish.
Well, I think yours the biggest. Sorry.
Well.
Well, who's the one showing cleavage today? It's kumquat.
You are.
I brought kumquats for you.
Oh, I love my kumquats.
I can't put them in there with the shirt on.
No.
I sound like a really perverted male. Right now, but I'm just saying.
I'll save them for later.
And we can't toss the kumquats, but go ahead.
So what I want to say is.
So you lost the bag and then you had all the other stuff.
That's, you know, like, yeah, that's water under the bridge right now. So what happened was I twisted my foot and I was having this excruciating pain for like a week. And I was asking my sister and her husband, my brother-in-law, I'm like, can I have some ibuprofen? I need some pain pills. And they're like, we don't know where they are. And I'm like,
you don't know where your ibuprofen is.
It wasn't mine. It was theirs.
And all women know where their ibuprofen is.
So I kept asking her every single day. She couldn't find it. He couldn't find it. So last night I was sleeping, right?
Uh-huh.
And the Lord came and says, ask them for the ibuprofen again because it's right there. It's right upstairs. It's right there.
Oh my God.
You know? And so I was like, this morning I woke up and I said, look, the Lord told me to ask you for the ibuprofen because I saw it. I know it's right there. And then they go, well, we haven't seen it in a while. I mean, where is it? So neither one of them knew where it was. I said, I'm going upstairs. I'm going to go in your bedroom. Can I get it?
And
she says, if you can find it, lo and behold,
it was
honey,
right there. Are you serious? I love when you get those messages, like those when you're not even thinking about it, and they come to you. Oh my gosh! There
800 milligram. Okay, take that pain away, Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you.
And then a
don't
quickie.
Take too many of those. Though.
I'll take as many as I need.
It causes tinnitus.
Well, I'm not going to get tinnitus. I drink enough H2O, and I drink alkaline water.
That's not what tinnitus is from.
Well, whatever. And so, wait a minute. So just to show you how this really works with the Lord telling me things, I went out with my boyfriend years before Ike. His name is Monday. Monday or Bingo
Way. Did I meet Monday?
He was an African, honey. No, you have never met him.
Oh
He's like God. Way back.
What a bizarre
so
name.
Anyway,
it's
he
a
took,
neat name, but it's interesting.
Thank you. Every time I think of Monday, I'm looking forward to Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, he was picking me up from a club. And, you know, we were together and he went to go get the car. I was standing in front of the club waiting for him and he bought the car around and I got in the car. Okay. I was wondering what took him so long. I didn't know. But so, okay. So we were in the bed late at night at 4 o'clock in the morning. I woke up.
Wait, what year?
I don't, before Ike Turner. Okay. So at 4 o'clock in the morning, I woke up and I looked at him and I said, why did you pee on that tree when you were pulling the car out? He said, oh my God, how do you know I was peeing behind the tree?
You never saw him.
No, I saw him.
But in your dream.
Like, it wasn't a dream. It's like you and I are sitting here. Oh. I saw him. You know how men get out and they use the bathroom?
Yeah.
Well, I was standing in front of the club door waiting for him to drive off. So there's no way I could have possibly been there to see it. But I woke up at 4 o'clock in the morning and literally slapped him on the head. I said, why did you pull out and pee and use the bathroom right behind that tree? He said, oh, my God. Oh, my God. Your vibration is so strong. You saw me do that?
Yeah.
So what I'm saying is, you know, I have those visions. I can see things when I'm not around. It depends on what the Lord wants to show me. Don't mess with me, honey.
Exactly.
But
exactly.
You can't use it like that. It's like, I can't, I can't, I have to be real.
Yeah.
And I don't, when I tell you that the Lord has showed me something, I can't lie because it's like, you know, that was real. I could tell you more, but I won't.
No, but that's fine.
Thank you,
fine.
God. Thank you. I just really
you,
praise
Jesus.
You and thank you for my visions that you show me.
Yeah, because when I have questions about God, a lot of the time I end up talking with you and one of your friends and your sister.
Yeah.
Your sister in Nebraska.
Randy, the minister.
Yeah. And I want to go to that one church and, you know,
okay, you can.
But the thing is we both get messages from God and that's what's really weird about not weird.
Well, I get visions. I mean, I like see you like I'm looking at TV.
Yeah. But that's like,
I call it a vision.
But if sometimes it comes when you're sleeping, so it's a dream. You
can
call it a
vision.
Yeah, that's
a message.
That's a message?
Yeah.
Well, okay. So a vision is like when I'm sitting in the car in traffic and I said, I have a funny feeling I'm going to run into Jeremy. And he walks by my car.
Okay, that's telepathy and God. I mean, God's showing you before it happened.
Right,
you
okay.
But you had a funny feeling.
I felt it that whole day.
That's fabulous.
But there's no reason, because it was after one of our shows on a Thursday.
That's
and there's
great.
No reason for me. And the thing is the errand I was trying to run, I had to be in traffic back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, because the guy didn't have the product yet. Oh. So the funny thing is like, I'm like, why am I driving back home when I have to turn around and drive another 3 miles in traffic
and
on the way back?
And you ran into Jeremy.
Yeah. It was so weird.
I'm going to say ew to Jeremy.
And then, no, but he walked right by my car and I'm like, Jeremy?
Bye,
and,
Jeremy.
Yeah. And he didn't know that my car, and then he's walking and then here I am driving in this really nice Lexus. We have, Audrey and I, by the way, have the same exact car, Jarvis. Mm. Isn't that weird? See, that's another weird thing is our car is the same exact color, the same exact style, except mine's light beige on the inside and hers is black. And but most people don't have
black leather.
Yeah. Yeah, I have beige leather.
Black, like I like my man, dark black leather.
You like him real dark.
I like him whatever color God wants to give him to me.
Exactly.
Although,
you know,
Ike was dark as night, honey.
Was he?
Chocolate. He was dark chocolate.
Thought he was like a dark chocolate, but not a dark, dark, dark chocolate.
I mean,
chocolate.
You know, yeah, I just say that. I mean, you know, he was just, the voice was very strong.
Yes, I know.
I just saw something on him. He's, you know, there's a whole TV show.
Oh, really?
With Ike Turner and the basically the best men in music.
Well, he was the best, and legend shall live on.
And it's an episodic that's on CMT.
Oh, I got to check that out for my baby.
Yeah, country music television.
Okay,
CMT.
Tell me the good news.
I like those cowboys. Okay,
right, them cowboy.
I actually had a dream when I was on my sidewalk when I was 7 years old that I was going to end up marrying somebody who wore a cowboy hat.
Okay, and if you don't end up marrying someone who wore the cowboy hat,
can you? I love horses and riding them,
I'll buy that cowboy hat.
I love my cousins own Arkansas pretty much, right?
Right.
Most of it.
Arkansas.
Like a lot of money, a lot of land, right?
Okay. Vacation.
You know, the Armenians, we love to garden. So
vacation.
Just give us the land and we'll make the fruit. But exactly.
I love
right?
it. Vacation.
Yeah. So it's really interesting because I'm like, why would I marry a cowboy? And now I do that Southern thing real well.
Oh. Well, tell me about this Southern charm look
here's
you got.
This
I heard
thingy.
You found your ring. What?
Oh, yeah.
Tell me about it.
So here's the deal.
Yeah.
After the show last Thursday, you, your sister, and I went to eat. We had a really lovely, you didn't get to come with us, Jarvis, but we went and had margaritas and danced on the, and tapas. We danced on the bar. We danced on a bar. We had margaritas after the show. We had lunch, right? But that apparently was margaritas. So then I said, I have to go to Ross. I have to go to Ross because I need to get my blackout curtains to finish my radio studio in my apartment so I can do shows that are just audio only from my apartment.
Uh-huh.
And then the thing is I went to Ross. And I was like, wait, I need to go to Target. Remember I kept saying I need to go to Target. For an entire week, I'm like, Audrey, I need to go to Target. I need to go to Target. I don't want to go to Target because you shop too much in Target.
Oh, right.
And it's a pain in the butt in LA. You've got to pay for parking. It's not like other cities and states. So if you're listening national, there are the pluses to not, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So of not living in LA, parking.
And I love LA.
Right. But we love LA, but you got to pay more for parking.
I love LA.
You were, there you go.
So what happened with
So I went to Ross and this guy, Jarvis, you're ruining my moment.
Tell me what, did you find something? Can you tell me that you found, you told
so
me you found
something.
So
I drove, something. No, you guys listen to this. So I what? drove into the parking space right in front of Target. Oh, she just brought us some more wine. This is Lindsay. This is our lovely friend.
Hi, Lindsay. And it's not Lindsay Lohan.
And I said, Lindsay, sweet pea.
She looks like Lindsay
Lohan. I said, Lindsay, get me some. You brought the wine. You see, now that's a good woman.
I got you.
You know, when you got it. You know, when you're, you know, serving the men on Super Bowl Sunday.
Did you?
Don't forget the bottle opener when you bring him a beer. I'm just saying.
Lindsay got this.
You know what
Thank
I mean?
You, Lindsay.
And don't forget the dip with the chips.
Yeah.
You're okay. That girl. I like that. So anyway, so here's my dip with chips. The thing is I drove up to the parking space. I get out of the parking space and I said, I'm going to run in there really fast. My whole entire goal was I want to go home.
Uh-huh.
And I have to still go by Target. And it's another block or two over. So and I was like, wait, OK, so just go. And I drove. And I said, just pull into Ross. Go look for the blackout curtains. You know, the sound protecting curtains. Just go in there really quick. You know exactly what you want. You know what color. You know everything. So I get out of the car and this Indian man from India with like, he had a maroon shirt, like silky. And then he had maroon pants. No, I'm not done. And he's right in front of my car. And I get out of my car and he goes, you're very special to God. And I go, huh? And I thought, oh, he's just another man hitting on me. Ooh. Like, literally, that's what my first impression was. He's just another man hitting on me because he said, you are very beautiful.
Okay.
He did include that in that comment.
That's nice. That's
and
so
then
nice.
I was like, okay, thank you. And he goes, I'm not. And but what he did was so important.
Yeah.
He goes, I'm not hitting on you. And yeah. I know you think that, but I'm here to give you a message from God.
That's fabulous.
And I said, what? And he goes, you're very special to God.
Yeah.
And he says, I have messages for you. And
okay.
He goes, and I'm standing here and I need to be at the Starbucks coffee three blocks down the street on Hollywood Boulevard. And I can't get there because I'm waiting for you. And you were supposed to be here 5 minutes ago. God told me you would be here, but you stalled.
Okay.
So, you know, when I got into the car.
It's very biblical. Could you please tell me what happened?
I got a parking ticket when we had lunch. So I stalled because I looked at the parking ticket. Basically, he told me some very, very clear signs. He also said, I am told to write this on a piece of paper. Before he goes, write what you tell me on a piece of paper. But if I put this crumpled piece of paper in your hand and you keep it locked in your fist,
yeah,
and you promise not to touch it, but only, you know, I'll tell you what to do. If it says the same thing that I'm going to write after we're done talking, will you then believe me that I'm sending you a message from God?
Yes.
And I said, yes. He had the paper crinkled up in his little ball.
Yeah.
Like a spitball. He goes, it's going to look like a spitball in his Indian accent. He goes, like what kids do in school, you know,
okay.
They make a spitball. So then I opened it up after we were done talking, and it was exactly what he wrote, that I saw him write.
Okay.
In the same font, in the same style.
Yeah.
In the same exact everything. Everything was exact.
And as
he goes,
what?
And exactly what I saw him handwrite. So
okay.
When I opened the piece of crinkled paper,
yeah.
It was the same exact font, the same
yeah.
writing, and it was the same everything he said. He said my age. He said how many brothers. He was very obsessed with, he goes, you have brothers. And he goes, I know you have two brothers, but and I said, well, one's older, one's younger. And so I said that to him. And then he asked me a couple other things. He goes, I'm going to give you a number. Give me a number. I'm going to give you like, just give me a number between this number and this number. And I gave him a number And then when I opened up the paper, like 20 minutes later when we were done talking, yes. it was the same exact thing that I actually
saw
him handwrite.
How awesome is that? Okay, so
but
then
he
what?
Also gave me messages. He okay. said, your career is taking off right now. You nice. Do not have time for more girlfriends. And nobody knows this, but I'm always like, I want to meet more girlfriends. I want more girlfriends to want to do things with.
Yeah.
Because I do things with you, but you don't go out like we should and
well,
prance around.
Well, because we're so
around.
Busy. We're so very busy.
I and know what's... we're busy, but we should be out in the world, in the sunshine, like at the beach.
Okay, and so
this
what's the next
LA.
Message? Can we?
Oh, the LA. Oh, the next message yes. is, well, I can't say.
Okay, and then what's next?
Well, anyway, so that's the point. Then at the end, he gave me his phone number.
Okay.
And his name.
Yeah.
And I called the phone number when I got home because right. I was really freaked out. I ended up going to Target in a daze and confused. Okay. And I was like, did this really just happen?
Okay.
So then I called the number.
Yeah.
And this woman with an accent, I think it was Spanish or something, was answering. I said, is Raj? Is this Raj?
Yeah.
And she's like, no. And I tried every type of phone number. Jarvis, what do you want to say? Yeah.
I met the same guy. It's amazing.
You did?
You did,
same
Jarvis?
Thing. Same guy.
You mean the Indian guy? When?
All black, right?
No, he wore maroon. And he told me not to wear so much black. That's why I'm not wearing black today.
Yeah, I met the same guy.
You? He?
When I first moved wow. out here, my first day of working, I
what
met
did he
him.
Say his name was?
Raj or whatever. He told me he was a yogi.
He didn't tell me that.
Well, and you said yours said he was some kind of...
No, he
but
said
he did the same thing. Like, I met him twice. I met him the first day I started working.
Yeah?
He gave me some messages or whatever. He just came what? Up to me. Said, I got some things to tell you.
They were... Right on.
Well,
right?
He said, "Hey, you're gonna, you know, you're starting something new." And I yeah. said, "Wow,
yeah.
I'm just starting this job."
Mm-hmm.
And then he told me some other things. And he just walked off. Okay, 2 years to the
yeah.
date.
Yeah, yeah.
When I got laid off,
yeah.
2 years to the date, I walked down, you know, to the beach, and I saw the guy. And I said, "Jesus, let me wait on." He was talking to someone else.
Yeah.
And I waited for him. I said, "Hey, I don't know if you remember me, but I met you 2 years ago to the day. You told me some things and so forth."
Two
he said, "Okay,
years
let's sit down."
The day.
We sat down, and before we started talking, he wrote something on a sheet of paper, a sticky note. He
uh-huh.
balled it up. He said, "Will you hold this while
uh-huh.
we talk?"
Yeah,
I said,
you
"Sure."
You have to hold it. Yeah.
So we started talking. He told me some things, but what he said was in the middle of, he said, "Give me a number and give me a color."
Yeah.
He just said, "Give me a number." I said,
he didn't
"Green."
Ask for a color.
I said, "13." We kept talking for another 10-15 minutes. He told me, he said, some things are going to happen in your life at that time, like in 3 or 4 months. Like, it's going to be a major thing.
Yeah.
He said, when you open this paper, everything's going to be confirmed.
Wow.
And when I opened the paper, it said green. He had written green in 13 before he even asked me the question.
Yeah, that's what Indian. Was he to have a little belly?
Yeah.
He had a little Buddha belly.
It's the same
guy.
But then listen to this, you guys. When I watched him walk across the street to rush to the Starbucks, he disappeared.
Yeah. It's a spiritual thing.
He was gone,
thing.
You guys.
Very
he
spiritual.
Was gone. It was the street.
I'm not
and that's
surprised.
When I went to Target, I said, and I sat there and I was like, wait, what?
Yeah.
He's wearing maroon. Like, you can't miss him. I know exactly where he was.
Right.
How could my eyes blink and the guy's gone?
Right. Because because sometimes people are there through the spirit to give you a message for that moment and they're gone.
There
it's
were
not
multiple
for you to call
messages.
Them
yeah.
and try to talk to them. That's not what it's
he
about.
He gives me a number in Orange County, right? And I said, oh, my dad lives there. I go there all the time.
But when they give you the message,
it's
for you. And they don't mind you sharing. That's if you choose to. Or if they tell you not to, don't share it. But when they give you something and it happens like that and it happens to come to
Jarvis,
fruition,
you didn't tell
it's
me.
The real deal.
I told you on the phone about him, didn't I? Oh, because he told, you know what he told me? He said, I want to make sure you do not tell anyone certain things I'm telling you.
Okay.
And he goes, because I know you'll call your girlfriends right after.
She did.
Yeah.
And I did, but I didn't say what he said. I just said,
you got a few things out of you.
Yeah. But no. He actually was, I'm talking like 10 or 15 messages.
Yeah.
Like, these things were hard. He goes, you know you need to write your screenplay, Heidi. And I was like, yeah. He goes, you need to write it. He goes, you're on a deadline. He goes, you need to, and he goes, I know you're busy and I know you have shows. He goes, but if you channel your energy correctly, you can do it. He goes, block a week out, write your screen. He goes, I'm giving you a message from God. You already know that you saw it in a dream.
Yeah.
You woke up and wrote it down. Why is it not typed? And I was like, okay. And I already have final drafts. So I'm like, I just
so
got to write
the thing.
It. That's the thing is I wasn't listening.
Here is the thing. Jarvis just said here and double confirmed.
Yeah.
What you're telling.
Right.
Because it happened to him as well. It's what's amazing. So everyone, God is amazing. I mean, he sends angels. He sends messages. He sends the messages come through people. So that is pretty awesome. Now, what I want to move on to is Brad Pitt and Angelina.
Well,
let's get to the news.
Okay, speaking of that.
What?
I found my parents' wedding ring.
What? Congratulations.
And I forgot to tell you, yay, it was last night when I stayed at my dad's house for 2 days down in Orange County.
Yeah.
Looking. And finally, I heard, like a week ago when I said, where is it? Where is it? I started panicking.
Yeah.
I heard a voice say to me, and I knew it was God. He's like, relax. It'll show up.
Peace be still. I always tell you that.
Okay, so, but no, Heidi had to go. Heidi had to say, is that really, is it?
Yeah.
Because imagine, like, my parents got divorced when I was 17. You know, I'm glad that Brad and Angelina are, they're
did you
get, younger.
So you found your ring, you
I found the ring, but guess where? It was in my, I have a lot of jewelry, okay, yeah, because my mother was a jeweler. So yeah, they were four very, very big rings and very diamonds. And I found the one my mother made for my husband.
Congratulations. Where was it? Where was it?
It was in the same entire, she gave me very nice things to lay your necklaces out,
yeah,
in.
Yeah. Oh,
and it was,
yeah,
I had wrapped it
like
in
a display kind
I
of
I had
velvet.
Wrapped it in a little special velvety bag, oh, and stuffed it behind one,
see,
of them. So if someone ever broke into the house, which they never would at my
they
father's,
never
but
will,
if they ever will,
yeah,
that I could hide it and they wouldn't know.
Well, congratulations. Yay.
I know.
That's
because
good news.
I'm Armenian and we hid jewelry.
That's
so
good news.
I did that. Thank you.
Okay. But I hide my jewelry too, and I am not Armenian.
Yeah, I don't know what Angelina's wedding ring looks like.
Well, here's the thing. Let me give you some celebrity news.
Oh, I know all about that.
Number one, Brad Pitt and Angelina agreed to co-parenting. Brad Pitt is now visiting the kids,
yes,
frequently.
That's great.
Matter of fact, he visits them when she's on the set filming her,
well, he
filming
should,
her new movie.
Yeah. He should.
He was babysitting the kids. How wonderful was that?
You know what? It's great because
what do you think about
that? I think that's, you know what? Let me tell you something. Mm-hmm. If you're going to have anybody on a set babysit your kids, mm, and your husband is not working, you're,
yeah,
damn right you should be picking him, even if you're splitting up from him, because you made a commitment with children.
Yeah.
And that commitment is something, and I know because my parents are still really good friends.
Oh,
they
that's
got divorced
good
when I was 17.
Yeah.
And I love my stepdad to pieces, and my dad and my stepdad are really good friends. I mean, like, seriously, like, it's just a connection.
That's awesome.
So I'm thinking, I don't know. I just remember when they got together was,
yeah,
when my ex-fiance and I split up. So I related to Jennifer because I was going through the same exact thing.
When who? Oh, okay.
Jennifer and Brad. Mm. But the whole thing with Brad and Angelina was that they were supposed to be so compatible and soulmates.
They're so beautiful, and they are,
yeah,
soulmates. But sometime your soulmate time is up. You know,
is like, that true?
I think so. Either they die or you divorce. If you, if it's meant to,
Audrey,
be.
Audrey, well, is there anything happy about die or divorce?
I'm just saying, it's a transition.
It's a DD.
You know what? Like my son, mm-hmm, and my son's father, who used to be my junior high school friend, I feel like he's my brother. Like we used to be very besties. I mean, I wouldn't touch him with a 10-foot pole if he was the last man on earth. But I like him as a brother. He likes me as a sister. He used to. But now he has a wife, and I can't even. It's like we don't have that same relationship.
You can't, yeah, she's jealous.
But his other girlfriends before, they were cool with me. Like, hey, Audrey. But, you know, and so I'm still cool with him. Like, I mean, that's, he's like family. And so whatever you need, I got you. And I got her too. But she's like, oh no, I mean, we can't be friends.
Well, you know,
it's just me and you. I'm like, okay, well, do you and you. But I still love you. I don't love you because, you know, you don't want to be loved. But I'm here. I'm cool. I'm a friend. I mean,
right. And so maybe
I think we should all be friends with our exes,
right,
but on a distance, you know. But and then, yeah, if you want to come and we could all have dinner, chill. I mean, I can bring my man if I had one. I mean, you know, I don't get this ugliness of don't
know,
talk to her.
But,
you're not.
Okay, but that's a jealousy thing. But
yeah.
I did hear at some point that Jen and Angelina were becoming very cool with each other.
Jen and Angelina?
At one point, I did hear that, and it was a secret, and it was like, well, the tabloids are just eating everything up, so they got to keep it floating. But at some, you know, and she's moved on to Justin, but I'm sure if
Justin,
and apparently Brad is dating Kate Hudson.
Yeah, Goldie Hawn's daughter.
Yeah,
she's so cute.
I
Brad
know,
is so
I
handsome.
I know, but he liked Gwyneth Paltrow. He normally likes blondes. So you have Gwyneth Paltrow. Well, no, he had Brad. I know his whole entire dating history. Juliette Lewis.
Yeah.
Gwen, and that was a long-term girlfriend. She's a fabulous actress.
Is she?
Oh my God, she's great. I love her. And then she dated, you know, Gwyneth Paltrow.
Yeah.
I mean, he dated Gwyneth Paltrow for 3 years.
Oh.
Right?
Okay.
So Gwyneth and him.
All I really know and care about is Angelina.
Jen,
I mean, they
and
were
him,
the bomb.
And
they
I
were
know,
beautiful together.
They were beautiful
so classy,
together. But
so sophisticated.
But she's the different woman that he, you know, compared to the others.
Yeah.
And so I thought, oh, this is it. He finally, like, this is the connection. So the fact that they've split up.
they're still friends. Now.
Now.
You know, you go through a storm and it's like, look, hey, what? It's not worth it. Life is too good.
They have six kids together.
Yeah.
There's going to be kids that are way more into one parent than the other at different times of your life.
I just think
Teenage girls are going to manipulate daddy. And so that's why you have
daddy's
to keep.
Girl.
But you got to keep the relationship going with the father, because if there's two different like bipolar things, the kids all over the place.
Well, did bipolar come in the picture right now?
No, I'm just saying you become. I'm saying if you have two people who are like one wants this polarized and then one wants this, they want to raise the kids differently. If you're not in cahoots, the kids are all over the place.
So it's great that they're co-parenting. That is the best news. Yeah. I have more good celebrity news. Now, did Joss? Mm-hmm. And Amanda, who found love last season on The Bachelor in Paradise, appeared to be getting back together following their January breakup. But guess what? Josh's assistant, Haley, is tossing up the details, honey. Just this past week, Josh had an appearance on The Bachelor, and Josh and Amanda got into a big old argument that night, and she ended up taking his things from her apartment that they shared and dumping them into the hallway, honey. Bye. How about that? And she complains she, the assistant, had to pick it all up.
Well, let me tell you why.
Why?
Because he's doing something behind her back, and they are not going to work.
Well, after all, she is the assistant, so go pick up those clothes in the hallway.
Okay, you toss those up, okay, in the laundry, and just toss them up in the dryer, and then toss them up in my closet, and don't toss my husband.
Well, that's already been tossed.
I'm just saying. So that's what's going on.
Yeah, so now she has to do assistant work.
Well, yeah.
And go pick up those clothes out the hallway that the wife just threw out.
But the thing is, you know, people think The Bachelor is a difficult show for me to watch.
Is it?
I don't know why. It just is a difficult show. So I don't know as much about it, but I did watch it. And I thought they were cute when they first got together. And then I realized, ugh, it's not going to work. But go ahead to the next one.
Okay.
Because I have my favorites.
Yeah, well, this is the news, honey. This is what's going on, honey.
I know what's going on, but I like my favorites, too.
Great. Mm-hmm. Honey, let me tell you now. Ivana, you know, in the White House, she takes the
official... You mean Ivanka?
Ivanka.
Yeah, Ivanka in
Did
the
I
White
say
House.
Ivana, too?
Is she living in the White House?
Didn't he have a wife named Ivana?
It was Ivana. That was
and
his
now
first...
he has Ivanka?
Ivanka's the daughter of them. Is she living in the White House, you guys?
Well, she takes the official office White House job as unpaid assistant to the president. Daddy Trump. Daddy's little girl.
I'm daddy's little
that
girl.
Is
I would
so
do that
cute.
Job.
I would
like,
too.
Hi, Daddy.
I
just went ahead and like told like the president of another country to go ahead and do what I said. And anyway, I just did it for you.
Daddy be like, don't push your limits, darling.
Daddy, can I have your credit card?
Yes. But you got to do the White House work. So, you know, okay. So life goes on.
No, but the thing is she now lives in the White House.
Yeah. Isn't that something?
So did you hear that him and Mel, pronounce it's not Melanie, is it? His wife? Hey, wait.
What's his wife's name?
Oh, Mel. Wait, she's so pretty. It's a different country. Melania?
Melania.
Yeah, Melania. See, I said Melanie or Bologna or I don't know. Melania. So just mix those two words together.
Yeah.
She is apparently sleeping in a different room.
Really?
Did you know that?
Why?
I don't know. Oh. He doesn't snore. It's because
maybe he's so busy and out of the country.
She's mad at him.
Really? Why?
Because she's actually very grounded.
Okay, she's but why would she be mad at Daddy?
Well,
I mean, President Trump.
I don't know. We don't know. We're not talking about politics at this point in the.
No, we're not. But you brought it up and said she was mad at him. So
I don't
I
know the exact
know
reason
why.
Because what I'm saying, but I do believe that she's probably sleeping in a separate room.
Well, that's nice. That makes everything even much more funner when they get together.
Well, that is lovely, yes. It's just like, great, I don't need to hear you snore, but I can have all your benefits.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, honey, these little women of Atlanta were really cute,
I think they're so cute. I told you that last week. I said, oh my God, they're so cute.
They are the hottest. These little women, like the little women.
They're pretty.
They have bottoms bigger than like dunk a chunk.
Yeah, they do, right?
They don't even need a bottom job. You know how you,
know
you get
why?
Those jobs?
I think my mother was right. The more yoga and stretching you do,
yeah,
Excuse me, I just had to stretch my neck.
Okay.
The more yoga and stretching, the taller you look and the slimmer you look. But the lower to the ground you are.
Oh, the bigger the bottom?
The bigger the bottom. So, because it's anchoring you to the ground.
And these women, they bring so much drama. Like I said, they're so cute. They have the shapes of life. There's these two little twins, the twerking twins.
They're so cute. The twerking twins are really pretty. If you look at these women in their face, just their faces alone, you would, oh my God, she's so pretty. But then you see them and they're like 3 feet tall.
They're
Right?
Don't mess with them because you get your knee bit off.
But the thing is these girls are pretty spicy. Like, you know, if you know, any man would be happy with one of them twerking around him.
So here's the thing. The twerking twins, they want to give up that twerking identity. Mm-hmm. They want to move on to something else.
There they are right
They're so cute.
Yeah, they are. They're super cute.
Yeah. So they want to move on to something else. Mm-hmm. They want to, you know, like upgrade their style or their status. And so now they want to be like party host. And so they have their first party hosting event and at the club Havana. Right?
They want to be party host. They want to be
party host and not twerking host.
Well, you know, at some point you got to grow up out of the twerkers.
Well, yeah, but they twerk so good.
Well, then they can save it on video.
Who does it better?
Well, do it privately for your man, but you know, but go ahead. So keep going. So that's their thing, is they want to just get out and grow up in the world.
Well, they're moving on. They are growing up in the world. So yeah. I mean, I love it.
I didn't think mean that.
Absolutely,
I didn't
the
mean.
Best.
I thought that was, but I think they're 3 feet. How tall are they?
Well, 3 feet is.
I wonder if we measured their rear end from the side to side, if it would be like, you know, if there's some kind of a balance. Because I have a perfect hourglass figure.
Yes.
Like you. So if you measure if you measure me, then it's like, okay, like it's a good figure as far as symmetrics are concerned, but you're saying that they've got banunkadunks. Their booty is just, you know, wide open. It's a, you know, it's a.
Oh, I didn't say wide open, but I'm just saying.
I'm just saying it's just.
Here we go.
It's open road there.
Oh, here
Hi,
we go.
Truckers.
She talked
Hi,
that
truckers.
Up.
I'm just saying. But you know what? These women,
ooh,
I get
that's
it. Yeah,
painful.
Yeah.
Wide open.
Right. Go ahead. Go ahead to the next show.
And then, you know, with the little girls, with the little pretty women, honey. Tanya, the one, what is her name? Taya or Tanya? She looks just like J-Lo, baby.
She's pregnant. So pretty.
She looks like a little miniature
and
J-Lo.
You know what?
She's pregnant.
They
and
always don't have dwarf babies. Their babies are normal size.
Yeah.
It's just a gene that's.
Well, here's the thing. Tanya's pregnant. Her and her best friend are not best friends anymore. Her best friend, who used to be her bestie, came back into town and didn't tell her she was in town because they were mad at each other.
Of course.
And she's apparently mad at Tanya because Tanya chose her baby daddy over her. Well, I would too.
You mean for what? For whatever.
For closeness or whatever.
Why would you get mad at a woman for choosing a man over... Hello, unless you're a lesbian, you shouldn't have an issue with
well,
it.
Well, I think she was mad at the way the man was treating her.
Well, yeah. Okay, I get that. Which, by the way...
But these little...
There's one of... this. I don't. It's Atlanta. Did you say Little Women of Atlanta? Is that who we're...
That's what I'm saying.
I didn't know if we were in L.A. or Atlanta. But... She, same thing. The guy's a jerk.
Wait a minute.
Okay.
Yeah.
The guy's an ass.
Was he?
I hate to say the ASS word, but the guy's an. He is.
He's
like, he goes, oh, I'm. She goes, I'm really happy that, like, I would like to have. I'm so glad that he wants to take the kids and that we get along really good for the kids. And he goes, yeah, I'll do anything for the kids.
They have as much drama as tall people do, or I should say normal sized people do. In fact, they bring on more drama. They're like, come on. And then when they're fighting and you pick them up.
Because they're trying to be heard. They're like, I'm right here. I'm right here. It's like a little fairy trying to jump up and down.
No, I mean, like, they're really drama. Like when the
I know. They
the twerking twins were doing their thing. And Abira, she got a little like jealous. She's like, I'm the best twerking queen there is. I do that for a living. I shake my bottom for a living. Mm-hmm. You know, she said, so let me see what you got. You know, she says, I'm not going to hide it. I get paid to do this. So she started a little feud with the twerking twins.
Mm-hmm.
And then she started dropping it like it was hot. I mean, the drama just sizzled. And so they started attacking each other. And then the bodyguards came and picked them up. They looked like little bitty dolls. Like, so cute.
It's, oh, Audrey. You're so cute. Do you know that there is a TV show?
Yeah, what?
It's Crown.
Yeah.
And one of the he must be a prince or a king. I forgot. It's in France. Crown, I think, is like the French hierarchy.
Uh-huh.
It's one of the most popular shows. I have it on DVD. I'll show you it.
Okay.
Because I'm in SAG, so I had to vote for the SAG Awards, and it was up for one. She cheated on her really cute husband,
uh-huh,
who happens to be gay.
Oh.
You know, back in the 15, 1600s, whenever Crown is, or was it 1800s? I don't know. Jarvis is pulling it up right now.
Okay.
But she actually has an affair with a midget little black guy. And he was super sweet.
Oh.
And she was pretty.
Wait.
And wait. Yeah.
Hold
so
up.
This
wait,
is what
back
I'm saying.
Into the black
and then
guy.
They have a baby
so
together.
Black guy.
Yeah. And then the thing is how her husband find out. And he didn't want it coming out that he and her were not sleeping together.
Wait.
Because he's sleeping with a man.
Is she regular size and she has this
she's
little midget?
Yeah, of course. She's on the TV show. She's a regular series. She's a series regular.
Is she in love with this little guy?
She fell in love with him. A cute little, and he was cute. He was sweet.
Oh.
And he was a little midget, cute little black guy.
Yeah.
But then how the guy found out that they had sex is he was always around her. He must have been her assistant or he was somebody. I don't know, but he always had access to her, of course.
Yeah.
And then she had a little black baby. And that's how the guy knew.
Oh.
That's how the husband found out and the entire country found out.
Ooh.
That she was sleeping with this. Because he was the only black man around her. And he was a cute little midget. So I'm saying love is love. And even if you're 3 feet tall.
Oh, love is love. I don't,
of course.
Really? Even if you're 3 feet tall? Well, that, I mean, I can do love
you
on.
You can't toss it up.
Toss that up. I don't want a little 3 feet mean talking about Audrey. Come here. I'd be like, what? Call me.
But see, I
take a bottle. I'd be like, what? Bam, bam, bam. What are you talking about? You go sit down. What? You cook dinner. You better go order dinner.
Wait.
He's 3 feet talking about Audrey. I'm like, oh, really? Mm-mm, honey, not with my brain. I'd be like running and stuff.
Oh my God, but they're people. You can't say that. What if you just love
somebody? I love them. I think they're, yeah, I love them. They are lovely people.
I think you love who
could
you love.
Could you do a 2 feet? Because you're not that tall yourself.
I'm 5'2".
Okay.
But anyway, so back to your news. That's his hand. Jarvis just gave us the 5 minute hand. And Audrey doesn't know what that means. He thinks.
Don't
that,
say that I don't know what it means, because you don't know what I know in my brain.
Yeah, well,
you see,
she's looking at you like, "What did you just do?"
No, I just looked
she's
at him
because smack you back.
No, I looked at him because I liked the way he lifted that hand up. It was like, "Hey, okay." It had nothing to do with Audrey.
Jarvis.
Don't know because Audrey does know.
Did you pull? Did so you pull up the little midget guy on Crown? You didn't see him. Oh, he was on the second season, like the entire season, and it was so funny because. Her husband would run off and have an affair with a gay man, and then
wait a minute.
She would run off and have an affair with this little
tiny man.
Yeah,
it must have been something big about that little tiny man.
Well, you know, I'm saying their feet may be. Well, I would think so. I mean, they have to be more grounded to their feet may be larger, and that may everything goes down. So it's a big thing.
Down in the DM.
There you. Well, you know, you got to get your size from somewhere.
Right.
You stretch it out other ways.
On another note, I just want to send a prayer out and a shout out to the DC missing teens.
Washington, DC.
Yeah. Why are all these teens coming up missing?
Let me tell you why. I just sold a by the way.
Wait a minute.
Closing is tomorrow on my
okay,
condo in DC.
Okay.
I know exactly what's happening.
The teens are missing.
There.
I want to send a prayer out. I don't want to really get into the politics, but I want the world to send prayers out to these missing teens. Families are hurting, mothers, sisters, brothers, and where
right.
are they? And what's going on?
Because
dear God, please
I
send them
know.
Back home. Send them back home. And you know, that's what we're going to put out. Just send them back. And stop all this missing
stop
stuff.
Stop the craziness.
Yeah.
The thing is in Washington, it's close to Maryland and Virginia. And also there's these, a lot of parks. A lot, like where Chandra Levy was. Like,
my brother,
because my older brother lived there.
Mm-hmm.
I went to work there for XM Satellite Radio.
Mm-hmm.
And we would go hiking every weekend. And he would be like, you're never allowed to go here without me or by yourself.
Well,
ever.
Listen to him, yeah.
Sugar, there's like Rockville, there's all these. I mean, it's unbelievable. And that's why it's kind of like the desert. But for some reason, we don't find as many dead people in the desert as we do hear about in something like D.C.
But here's the thing. They're not finding them dead. They're finding them not finding them, like missing. So Hear it, toss it up. We want to send a prayer out to the missing teens, and we want them back home. Thank you, God. Just bless them, cover the families, and thank you very much.
Maybe they just went gambling.
Well, we don't know.
Here's,
I want to talk about...
I have more news, though.
What you got?
So, really quick, my favorite news show, and I don't know why I've got on the show because it's awful, Hoarders. Hoarders is painful to watch because it's difficult to watch, but there are people who really have that condition.
Do you know someone personally? I've met a couple of people who have a condition.
Oh, but you know what's funny is I would be like, Mama, why is their house so dirty and cluttered? Because our house is always neat and clean.
Yeah.
Right? And then she's like, I don't know, but do you really learn people? Like, if you're not a hoarder, you can't be married to a hoarder.
Of course not. That's disgusting.
And if you're a hoarder, there's no room for another hoarder.
No, there can't be two.
So you have hoarding and hoarding, and there's no room for love. That's their defense mechanism. It's like a block for what they really... It's interesting to watch the psychology of it, because I do hoard lipsticks, by the way.
Well, let's talk about hoarders. What makes people hoard? Let me tell you what makes them hoard.
They had a painful experience. Somebody stole my lipstick, so I have 20 lipsticks with me.
We can equate that to that. Okay. But I think it's because they're afraid. We have a caller.
Okay, as long as it's about hoarders and lipstick. No,
be whatever.
Hi, it's Heidi Selexa and Audrey Turner with Toss It Up. Hi.
Hi.
Well, hello, caller. What's your name and where you're from?
Hello. Well, she lost her lipstick.
Give her a chance.
Well, sometimes when you reach in your purse, you drop the phone. I'm just saying, when you look for your lipstick.
Okay. Well, until they come back, let me explain to you why hoarders are hoarders. Mm-hmm. Hoarders are hoarders because they're afraid of change, afraid to let go.
Right.
So they pile up on cards, on pictures, on a piece
of gum wrappers.
Gum wrapper. You read my mind.
Yeah, right?
We're in tune.
Gum wrappers from like 1985.
Pizza boxes. That was a good pizza.
A piece of gum that somebody gave them in the 5th grade or in the 12th grade or for
clothes
prom,
that they'll never be able to fit because they're 20 pounds larger.
Exactly.
And shoes that are ran over or just stuff. And then it compiles with papers and papers and more papers. Stuff that should be shredded. Well, this causes dust mites. It causes dust. It causes pollution in the air.
But it causes you not to live.
It's so unhealthy.
It is.
And then what it does, if your surroundings are cluttered, your mind is cluttered.
Always cluttered. And I know, because to me, when I say to you, I brought bags of treats today I was going to show you.
Yeah.
Because my mind is a little cluttered.
Oh.
But it's not stuff I'm hoarding. I'm saving it for the right opportunity. Now, that's different. And I'm not hoarding it or saving it.
Okay.
You get it? So I'm not a
hoarder. Well, thank you for bringing it.
And I'm glad I found my parents' wedding ring that I hoarded behind my...
I'm so happy for you.
My jewelry of my entire life that my family has given me.
I'm happy for
that's you. That's a hoarder.
Okay.
I have a little bit of a hoarder.
That's
I save
a different
lipstick.
Meaning.
I love lipstick.
Well, okay. I hope you use it. So what's your plans for the weekend?
Apparently, I don't have any on because you wouldn't have said that.
What's your plans?
Okay. That wasn't very nice.
What?
You said, I'm glad you should use it.
I didn't say that. I said, I hope you use it. You're hoarding it.
I didn't have any on. I talked during the whole show.
You do have it on. I see it on the edges.
I don't know what my plans are for the weekend. Isn't that funny? My condo is closing tomorrow.
Yay, woo-woo. I'm so happy for you. Congratulations.
In Washington, D.C., right
that's
there
beautiful.
In the car barn on Capitol Hill.
So that's
Hill.
Exciting.
It's sad because I loved it. It was my memory of XM.
Well, don't hoard
and,
it.
And like my entire career. Like I bought that home by myself.
Yes. Well, that's when you know you're moving on and you're transitioning and you're letting go. And it's time for new things.
And I said, Daddy.
Time for new
Daddy,
things.
Should I roll the money into another property because I don't want to get hit with 50%.
And Daddy said?
He said, not yet. And I said, can I give Ronnie, my younger brother, your other son, money to invest because he turns money over really quick?
What did Daddy say?
He goes, you can just give him a couple thousand.
Okay. So
and
Daddy
so
has
Daddy,
you.
No, my brothers have me. Because then he goes, I'm taking half and putting it in an account
for
you.
So the phone is ringing. I hear
Daddy.
The phone ringing.
Hi. Hello. Welcome to Toss It Up. I'm Heidi Selexa and this is Audrey Turner.
Ah!
He says it's not there.
Okay. I'm Audrey Turner and we're signing off. And
we can do live on Facebook right now.
We had so much fun with you.
Toss It Up.
We toss that up.
Ooh. Toss that up, girl.
Mm-hmm. Toss it up.
Toss it up.
Hey. Ooh. Toss it up.
Toss it up.
Come on, toss it up.
Toss it up.
Toss it up.
Up, up.
Ooh, toss it up.
Up, up.
come on, toss it up. Toss it up. Come on, toss it up.
Toss it.
Ooh, toss it up.
Toss it up.
Come on, toss it up.
Toss